Welcome back. It's quiet. It's relatively quiet. So welcome back to Let's Interactively Play Steve Jackson's Sorcery. This is a Let's Play where at the end of this video you get to choose one of the choices that I have before us and leave your comments and votes in the, well, comment section, and we will, you know, do majority vote or die roll if it's a tie, and we will, you know, take the winning choice going forward with the next video. So, I always say this just for anyone new who might be turning in. Votes are very, very welcome, so please vote if possible. I notice we have full stamina. That's pretty good. I think we got that over here. I think we got that here. I finally made it up here, and I'm glad about that. For two dragons last episode, and now coming across the Time Dragon. You crest the edge of the rocky pit and look down. The coiled shape you saw earlier is still there, curled up, apparently asleep. So I tried to cast a spell, I clicked on that. You begin to cast a spell, spreading your arms wide, but of course you only have one arm. The other was lost on the climb up the hill, don't you remember, which is strange? Because I did not lose an arm. You guys can watch towards the end of last episode. It had something to do with a weird dream. At least I hope I didn't lose an arm. I mean, if I lost an arm, would I really still have full health, right? The dark sheep uncoils, turning its vast jaw towards you with what is clearly a smile. Now, this is the time... Oh, I said dragon, didn't I? Not the time dragon, the time serpent, one of the seven serpents. I think we have two more to defeat, and this is the... Well, one of them. You guys voted... majority rules here. Voted to reach for my sword. You reach for your sword, but your hand is empty. You have no sword, of course. How could you have forgotten? You lost it in the storm on the lake, just as you lost everything. I am death, the serpent says, speaking with grandiose slowness. I devour all, destroy all. Nothing can withstand me. I end all. I shall end you. I have already done it. Welcome to your death. We don't have a sword. I think we're like floundering and... Are you... I have a hefty arrow. 26 gold pieces. I have a spell book. Oh. Time Serpent on a southwest island. Oh. Well, I knew that. All I have is a snake belly key. I have nothing, no items, no magic items. I have some of my other items. So this is like a past me from before I got this stuff somehow, because I'm being affected by the Time Dragon. Who are you? You demand. I am finality. I am closure. I am the cessation of all movement, which lies unborn in birth itself. You are the Serpent of Time. The serpent nods. So I am. So I am. And all times are as one to me. The serpent turns about and seems to yawn. Okay, I have one option to turn and run. Apparently I can't cast spells because I only have one arm. The only weapon I have is one hefty arrow, so yeah, I think it's a good idea to turn and run. You turn and run, but you cannot. Your legs are buried several rocks deep in the ground. The serpent seems almost to chuckle. All endings much have a moment in which they end, he remarks. This is yours. No, that was yours. I tried to run for it. I cannot attack? You move to attack with your fists alone, but somehow you cannot. But don't you remember? You died yesterday. You were eaten while you slept. The serpent rolls over and returns to sleep. You died well before you met the Time Serpent. I don't think there's any option here. This might have something to do with it, because this goes back in time. Maybe I want to not have it pointing there. Leaving the tower? Can I go back to the tower? Return inland. Now that you know the path, you waste little time in finding your way back to the base of the tower. True, true. Door to the tower stands open. Okay. Let's adjust the beam. Away. Is there anything else pointing there? Yeah, that's aiming that way, that way. I don't know where that's pointing, but that's far away. That way, that way, that way, okay. Let's give it a try this way. In present time. Just retracing my steps here. Oh, am I back from before I killed the other dragon? To do. Draw my sword and then, yeah, throw the oil. Yeah. Triumphant again. Alright. Let's see if anything changes now. I'm still on the path of something. It knows I rewound. You crest the stony rise with a curious sense of deja vu, and look down into a pit in which a coiled serpent lies. It opens one eye as you approach. You again, the serpent murmurs. One death wasn't enough for you. You want to have another? I will make it different this time. It has knowledge of my rewind. Now, just so you know, guys, if you're unfamiliar with the game, when you rewind stuff from before, it's like loading an older save. That stuff never happened. But this knows. This serpent knows what happened. I'm gonna ask it, what does it mean? You demand, voice quivering. What do you mean? Forgotten me already? The creature replies. You came off the worse for it, as I recall. But you will see what I mean by that soon enough. Or recently enough, perhaps. You're the Serpent of Time? I am, the creature replies, and you are the Annalander, the curse of the Backlands. Do you know I have been sent to destroy you for what you did? I have done nothing. Oh, no. You have brought desolation and destruction to this whole land. Whole cities, villages. You have wiped out families, fields. Do you not say you did not know you were doing it? What are you talking about? Ah, you did not see. To live inside time as you do. I can hardly imagine it. The serpent's tongue seems to flicker, and a moment later you are clutching the deep wound in your side that you sustained 3 hours earlier. Out on the lake, it is still bleeding. Deep wound, and I've lost 2 stamina. What kind of items do I have now? It says I have an option to attack, or run, or plead for my life. Well, I have my sword. I have some treasure. I have rations. I have my magical items. More keys. A lot more items. It seems like I have everything. Let's try attacking. Why the hell not? You step, but the dragon has made good its promise. You are dead before you can act. Wow. You died well before you met the Time Serpent. Now, I don't know if that means that you died well before, meaning, like, way before you met the Time Serpent, or you died well, like you died in a good, honorable way. I don't know. Okay, so, yeah. Okay, I have an idea, though. I hope I can still encounter the last dragon. You know what? Let's see if I can just take care of that. Take care of this dragon. And then I'll see if I can go back. You know, without rewinding, of course. Now it's here, I think. I investigate. I row away. I draw my sword, but not really. I throw something, which is the oil. I didn't mean to do that. I could have gone straight there. Okay. So at least when I rewind, if I have to, I won't have to defeat that serpent again. Okay, so I have an idea. Who knows it works? Not sure what he's talking about. I destroyed everything. Am I the Archmage? Does a future me turn out to be the Archmage? If anyone knows, guys, do not tell me one way or the other. Thank you. Yeah, no spoilers. We have a whole new fourth chapter to get through. Adjust the beam. Okay. I'm putting the beam back here. It's so awkward controlling this. I need like a mouse, change mouse YX thing. Okay, now I'm touching the blue crystal. I'm going here. I don't know if I can reach over the mountain. We'll see. I'm adjusting the beam. It does look like it's reaching over there. It looks like it's reaching. This might even reach. I don't know if this will work, guys, but it is a feeling I have, because it is the Serpent of Time, so. And these work on time. Just a beam. I don't know if this will, yeah, it looks like it's reaching, kind of. I want to make sure it's, yeah. Hopefully it's accurate as it looks. Now I don't think this one will reach, but I'll give it a try as well. Holy teleportation, Batman. Does look like it could reach, doesn't it? Like that more narrow and longer beam. Okay, so now we're just going to go back to our original island tower here. I was like, why am I going over there? I wonder if there will be any other strange effects from this. Someone took the boat. Right, because we've gone back to the past. But the pole with the bell seems to have vanished. Huh. Am I farther back in time, actually, to before they even put these bell poles up? Ah! It ruined my apples. You gather your strength for the cold and run into the water. Once again, your fragile possessions are ruined. Your spellbook is getting soggy, but remains otherwise intact. But all of your soft food has been ruined. I pay good money for that crap. I hope I didn't lose anything else. Magical items, I think, would be immune. At least mostly. So still have... Making sure I have everything. I do have a hefty arrow. I thought that was something from, you know, whatever time I was in when I lost my arm. Treasure. Seem to have a good amount of stuff. You'd think a tinderbox wouldn't work, but I need to find somewhere to cook this food. I have so much raw food. I wonder if when I find a place to cook it, when/if I'll be able to cook it all. Swimming like this is hard work. Darkness closes in. You need to rest, especially after swimming all day without food. You rest, holding up your head and catching your breath. But the shoreline is too rocky and rough to swim ashore. You will have to keep going. Okay, going this way. The statues. Day 28. You ran out of provisions and you defeated the water serpent again. So you've now destroyed 5 of the Archmage's serpents. You've been awake all night and weaker for it. 11 points. You must move on. Why is there an X there? Because that's where I defeated the serpent? You keep a steady pace as you make your way across the lake's surface. The day is likely to be clear and will be hot once more. Swimming like this is very tiring. The sun is hot now. You stop briefly, wiping your eyes. You have swum within reach of a rocky island. You cannot keep swimming without a break. Now, I don't want to waste my, blimberry juice. You splash through the shallows to the shore. It is very warm now. I don't want to waste my blimberry juice. Whenever we fought the Time Serpent... Well, we haven't really fought the Time Serpent. It's just killed us. So we didn't even get a chance. So I'm thinking that either it's going to be defeated easily or we're not going to have a chance. It doesn't look like you fight... I could be wrong, but it doesn't look like you actually fight this thing. The island is nothing but piled boulders and rubble. In the distant water, you see a fleet of fishermen row past and catch a moment of their singing. Let's rest and recover. Anyway, you adopt a meditative position and rest. The afternoon is starting to draw on. Good. 13 or 17. You get to your feet. Explore. You clamber up the rocks to the middle of a small island. I got special stuff. You head away from the shoreline up the rocky slope of an island. Yeah, new text here. There was something very strange about this place. The air moves with insects who seem sometimes frozen in mid-flight, but at other moments spin through the air. Clouds stop, shift, then stop once more. It is as though the whole island is running on ticking clockwork. The air shines and glows with the overlapping light from the beacons you have converged onto the island. It is as though a battle of elemental forces is being waged in the air itself. Let's look ahead. Same. A coiled shadow, but cannot make out. I'm just going to keep climbing. You continue climbing up the strange dead slope. The path turns and descends into a bowl-shaped pit. Hello there. You crest the stony rise and look down at the pit below, where a coiled serpent lies sleeping in the middle of the intersecting beams of light from the towers. The creature has not yet noticed you. In fact, it seems to be still, the only unmoving thing on this busy, bustling little island. Huh. Well, what kind of spells can we cast? Let me just check out. Well, I have two arms, which is good to see. I'm not missing an arm. I can cast spells. I really don't like them. Is that a future me who only has one arm? Can't be a past me. Because how do you just grow arms like that? Okay, explosions. These are, teleportation. That's, lightning zap. Oh, that's that. I checked out P and Z, G. Illusion of worship. What's that? Illusion of worship. Let me look at my spell list. I don't remember that one. God. Oh. Lesser... It's like a lesser charm. I could charm the thing, maybe. I mean, who knows if I'm close enough. It looks like I still have to creep up on it. Or get closer in some way. The only way I can do that is to creep up on it. I can, yeah, enlarge myself. P, G, Z, B. What's B? Oh, that's big. Remember that. Depression. Oh, SSS? I don't have the serpent ring. I would talk to it, actually. I would do that. That would be interesting. Cause stupidity. These are all valid things. And if I die from creeping up on it, I'd probably go back and choose one of these. I think that's it. Okay, I'm gonna creep up on it. You try to approach stealthily, but stumble and slip down the loose mountainside, sending loose rocks flying with each step, but the creature does not look up. Indeed, the creature does not react to your presence at all. It appears quite immobile. Run it through? You waste no time, and none of your advantage, but you draw your longsword and skewer the creature through the neck. Blood pools around its feet. Very slowly, its eyelids open as though they were pinned by weights. Then it chokes once, and the light inside its eyes goes dark. Is it dead? Yes! Oh, wait. It's alive once more. You stride over and check the beast's heart, but there can be no doubt. It is over. It is dead. Waiting for the music to subside, and you have now defeated 6 of the 7 serpents. Something is happening to the island. It is alive once more. The first thing you notice is the clouds. As they start to hurry across the sky, the grass begins to shift and move in a light wind. A few loose rocks skitter down the slope. The island is moving once again, and light from the beacons fades from view, and you feel a great wellness. But you feel a flush of satisfaction. Only one serpent remains. None of the others would be reporting your mission to their master. I'm going to return to the shore. We have full stamina now. But now your quest will not wait. You head back to the shore. Well, I don't know where to find the last one. Hold on. Let me just check something. The wind ruffles the short, thick grass, and birds flap lazily across the sky. The place feels as though some great curse has been lifted. That's awesome. You take a moment to rest, absorbing something of the quiet of the island. The evening is drawing in. Soon it will be dark, and now you must move on. You head back to the shore. You return to the shore of the lake. A flock of winged Meridians pass overhead, calling to each other in guttural voices and laughing. What are those? Guttural voices. I guess they're not birds? Winged Meridians? Meridians? You plunge down into the water and begin to swim. Need a boat. You swim on through the water. It is exhausting work. The sun is almost set and the sky has turned a deep purple. I'm heading back. I'm going to teleport to the other tower. I should try to rest, that's what I mean. Okay, I don't have an option to move from here, at least not yet. Swimming like this is hard work. Once more, you're at the south shore of the lake, but it is not now as you saw it last. The magnificent stone harbor is set between the two towering statues of sorcerers who reach to the sky as though to pluck down the constellations directly. The Zaman Road. You could clamber ashore, but the road to High Zaman begins from the harbor. You have survived the Backlands, but you have not defeated all of the 7 serpents. You could race on or turn back and try to bring down your remaining foe. See, I don't know where that dragon is. You swim onwards across the surface of the lake. It is hard going and frighteningly cold. The stars turn in the sky overhead. You know what, though? I have no rations. What I was thinking is go to this tower, teleport back here, well, to this tower, get some more provisions, but I might have to swim again. I think we want it like this, don't we? I think it's cheesy to rewind it, so I'm just gonna go back here and then up. You are back by the fallen boulders and stones of the broken harbor. Move away. There's no way ashore here. Okay, I'm rewinding. Wait a second. Is it here? I want to get that high Zeeman prompt again. Yeah, Zeeman Road, rather. I'm gonna move on because I have no idea where that serpent is. You drag yourself exhaustedly up onto the shoreline. The moon sets, more stars appear. You have successfully crossed the wastes of Kakabad. The road to High Zeeman winds southeast from here, but some of the Archmage's serpents still remain. But one. If they reach High Zeeman before you, then your mission will be discovered and the guards of Mampang will be expecting you. Well, it's one serpent. Hopefully I will be successful. Check out the statues, I guess. You look at the two broken feet that stand at the harbor's edge. Once this would have been the most impressive sight in the whole of Kakabad, a testament to the will and power of the sorcerers of High Zeeman. Now they are leveled. The sorcerers of that place are no more, and only the Archmage remains. And with the crown in his hands, he is unstoppably powerful. Surely, even after so much, your mission is still doomed. Something glints between the statue's toes. You know, guys, once again, don't say anything, please. But, that's even if you don't, if you know, but... I'm wondering if that's us. If we are the Archmage. If this traveler becomes the Archmage. So you're going to get the crown of kings from the Archmage. Then you have the crown of kings, and then you start doing the things that the Archmage is doing. I'm gonna look for what's there. You look closer. Set in the wedge between the fourth and fifth toe of the left statue is a small blue crystal. Oh, is this stamina? You touch the blue crystal and find yourself ascending. We can go back now. I'm gonna go here. After all. Since now we have another chance. I wanna get some fish. Oh, the fish is raw, isn't it? I'm gonna adjust the beam to more encompass the fishing village here. Rest. Putting down your pack on the shore of the lake. What? I'm not on the shore of the lake. You try to stretch out despite the shivering cold of your still wet clothing. You've eaten nothing today, but you have no provisions, only two vials of blimberry juice. You unstopper a vial of blimberry potion and gulp down a mouthful. You feel a little better, and all traces of hunger are soon gone. Then you close your eyes and let your tiredness overtake you. You seem guarded here, and you do not dream. Day 29. You defeat the Serpent of Time, leaving only one more serpent to destroy. You wake after a peaceful night and gather up your pack once more. Yeah, I hate to leave things undone, but I don't know where that is, and we could spend forever walking around in here. It might be one I can't get to. You leave the tower base. The sky is blue and pink. Now, if my... It all depends if I can get a boat. If I buy apples and they get ruined, then what's the use? I'm just going to rewind it. Now the fish is raw, right? I can't cook this stuff. So the only thing is fruit. Eight gold. No sense in buying more fish. Wait for nightfall, leave the shore or swim. Yeah, that's it. I'm rewinding. That's the only reason I came back here. I can't bring it with me, because I've killed the, it was the air serpent. And the air serpent was the ferryman. Yeah. So there's no more ferryman and there's no more boat. There's no time to waste. You'll have to try to race the remaining serpents to the fortress instead of defeating them. Perhaps you will be able to reach the fortress undetected, but in your heart you doubt it, of course. Well, it's only one serpent. I've got to say I'm at least hoping it's better with six serpents defeated. Hoping it makes a difference. Than like not doing anything. You begin the slow climb. Ahead, the stony road leads into the Zanzunus toward the fortress at Mampang in the final stage of your quest. One serpent is still free, but there is nothing you can do about that now. You have taken 29 days to cross the Backlands. It is almost certain that the Archmage has received word of your journey from the remaining serpent. You walk on, disheartened. Oh, crap. Let's hope we're equal to the task. As you walk, you are stopped by a man, bent double under a great load. His presence is most surprising on the empty road. You, he demands breathlessly. You are going to High Zaman? I am? He nods. Of course you are. He adjusts his grip on his heavy pack. I'm going home, he tells you. Home is Kariyama, a little village over the lake, over the marsh. I'm sure you won't know it. Do we? I think we might. Oh. This is it. I have been there. I know it sounded familiar. Pretty sure I've been there. A long way. You answer. Just across the bridge, less than a day, he replies. Then his mood darkens, a frown crosses his face. Only I was worried by something I heard while leaving. What did you hear? The birdmen up at the fortress were talking, you see, about the beacons. They said the beacons were emptying the land. I'm a simple peasant. I don't know anything about magic, but I'm headed home as fast as I can. Emptying it? You demand, catching his arm? I'm not demanding, I was just asking. How can a beacon empty anything? That's what they said, he says with some agitation. They said the beacons were wiping out whole villages, leaving only bare rock and dust behind. It sounded so strange, but then I heard the rumors that Tin Pang had been turned to a ruin overnight, and all the people gone. His voice drops to a whisper. They said it's been done by the most evil sorcerer in the land. Who is that? They call this sorceress the Annaland. Someone saw her turn the light onto Tin Pang, and then it was gone. What? Wait, I thought I was just traveling back to another time. I'm really affecting these things, but I turn it back? That's not possible. I don't know why anyone want to do it. Kariam is a harmless place, unless she wants to hurt it to hurt the Archmage. The man shrugs. But listen, you look like a strong sort, so I tell you what, if you see this sorceress, Annaland, then you kill her for us. Jeez. I am the Annalander. You reply coldly. Oh, I don't want to say it coldly. The man begins to reply, then his mouth falls open, and he cannot speak. He shivers. Curse you, then. He manages finally. You destroyed us all. With that, he shoulders his pack once more, and hurries away down the path, to be quickly lost in the mist. Are you serious? Well, Tin Pang's back. No, it's not. Wait. Tin Pang was already like this. If I adjust the beam, Tin Pang will be back. Should I have left it like that? And Kariyama. I can't shine that one, but this one is shining pretty much at Kariyama, back towards the past where, you know, things are alive. Have I inadvertently destroying places? That's what we got a clue of from the Time Serpent. I don't know, guys. This is crazy. Well, that makes me rather sad if that's true. Upwards, onwards. This was once a grand road. There are hints of gold leaf on the corners of the steps, carvings and holes for lanterns in the pillars that line the way, but all has long since fallen into disrepair. The only inhabitants remaining are birdmen, cursed to the air, that shriek like demons to each other. The only thing I'm hoping is that they're mistaken. They're seeing me change things. But if I change it back, it's back, you know what I'm saying? But that town was like that. Tin Pang was like that when I got there. I changed the beam and went to the past. Because when everything's alive, that's back in the past and this is the present. That's, again, enforcing my theory that I become the Archmage. Meaning, maybe I haven't done these things yet. I don't know. It's getting confusing. Upwards? The night is dark and cold, and in the meager moonlight, you begin to make out the shadow, a shadow in the distance. Okay, I'm guessing I'm looking at this, not the bird. Yep. Mampang. Tall spires and sharp angles make the building look like a rusted blade. One thing is certain, entering the fortress will undoubtedly be the most perilous stage of your journey. We can find some food somewhere. To Mampang. Your journey across the Backlands is complete. You took 29 days to cross the Backlands. In the course of your journey, you defeated 6 of the 7 Serpents, left the Sightmaster Sergeant in his last moments, met Althera the Mystic, encountered a Grimalkin, and met Fenestra, the Sorceress of the Forest. You lost a tooth. You learned that all spells can be countered, and a riddle about the Sleepless Ram. You collected a fantastic number of magical artifacts. You are armed with a long sword, and your original sword, and have no rations, 26 gold pieces, and a spellbook. The adventure concludes in Sorcery 4, The Crown of Kings. Coming soon. It's out. It's out already. Well, thanks for watching, guys. No vote this time, obviously. We're finishing on finishing part 3, the Seven Serpents, continuing on to the final chapter, part 4, which will be next week. So, yeah, unfortunately no vote, but the next episode will be coming up on New Year's Day. So, new year, new chapter of Sorcery. If you guys are watching this on the day I came back, and if you celebrate, Merry Christmas, or Happy Holidays. And yeah, thanks so much for watching, guys. Still all comments welcome about what you think is going on. What do you think is up with the towers and me? Thanks for watching, guys. See you next week.